Hell of a story. Superintendent of school left his gun inside of a bathroom. A third grader found it because the teacher told the third grader to go get it. They are completely jacked up at this institution. Let's put up the building full mass here. In Rising Star, Texas, district staff confirmed Superintendent Robby Stuteville submitted his resignation from Rising Star, effective immediately as of Monday, February 20th. The superintendent is resigning days after parents in the district learned he left a firearm unattended in a school bathroom for a third grader to find. There's more. Last week, the superintendent confirmed a third grader found his gun in the bathroom at Rising Star Elementary School in January and notified a teacher immediately without moving or touching the weapon. Is that not ironic? The third grader showed more discipline and responsibility than the gun carrying superintendent of school, who decided to walk into an elementary building with a gun. He's the superintendent of school. There's more. All right, so the superintendent walked KTAB and KRBC through the incident, explaining that both he and the school principal, they open carry, right, on the campus of the elementary school. When he was using the restroom, the superintendent says he took the gun off and placed it in a stall where it was then left unattended for around 15 minutes. Only takes 15 seconds for something insane and deadly to happen. It was found by a student. Now, let's put this picture up. I'm going to give you some more background, which is quite disturbing. Okay. Giovanni Mata, a gun owner and the father of the third grader, told KTAB News how a teacher sent his son to check on the gun after another student reported it. Keep the picture up. Literally, you have a school teacher who is being told, "Hello, Mr. or Mrs. School teacher, there's a gun inside of the bathroom." The school teacher says, "All right, well, let's send this other child to go in and get it or see if it's there." Mata, who recently moved to the area from where Uvalde, of all places, okay, said, "Why would you send a kid and not someone else? You know, I have a novel idea." Walk, as the teacher should have, walked their happy ass up in that bathroom to confirm if the children were in danger because a gun was left in there. Mata even reflected on last year's deadly mass shooting. "Be put in my shoes, 3 minutes for that guy to kill all those people in just 3 minutes, and this gun was left unattended for 15 minutes, he said. Nearly 30 parents showed up to an emergency meeting Thursday night. Their general consensus was that they did not feel that the superintendent was acting maliciously, as one parent said, but they were not happy being kept in the dark for so long. Put him up. This is insane. Put up the chief. All right. So that's the chief of police. Rising Star Police Chief Don Braley confirmed an active investigation began Wednesday after his office was notified of the incident. It's called negligence. It's called child negligence. Chief, if you have problems finding the statute, I looked it up. I can provide the code to you. Chief Braley says the Eastland County Sheriff's Office took a phone call, and that was the first time anyone had alerted law enforcement. Oh, it's a cover up too. Obstruction of justice, chief. That's the other statute. Failure to report a crime against minors. That's the third one. It's a stretch, but I think I can make it work. Do you need some help? This was the first time anyone alerted law enforcement, despite the gun being found in January. KTAB and KRBC posed a question to chief. If there is also an investigation underway into the failure to report, there it is. That's the fourth one, failure to report. And he said he is currently looking into the legalities. You have a duty to report these things. Everyone who works with children understand their duty to report. You literally put your signature to that duty. Everybody failed in this system. Now, let's go back to the parents. The parents, according to the story, they really weren't upset at the superintendent for putting all of their children in danger to be killed. They were upset because the school took too long to tell them about it. All right. Even though we will follow this story, I do not expect something more to happen. I'm surprised the superintendent, given the response from the community, which has been lackluster, is even resigning. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
And how much money did he take with him? I don't know what's going on in this school district, but everything is dippy. Okay, right down to the chief saying, and we're going to investigate facts, not rumors. Chief, there's no rumors here, okay? The dippy superintendent left a gun unattended in a stall. And the parents are saying goofball things like, we shouldn't be pointing the finger here, okay? Yep. We got guns in our homes. Who are these people and what is in the water? Can the EPA check that out? I know they're busy, but can they check that out?
It may be time. We have a regional director. His name is Daniel Blackman. I'm going to send this over to him after the show. All right, EPA director.